From the campus studios of Saarland University, this is Ropecast, a lighthearted podcast for learners of English, with Roger Charlton and Peter Tisha.
Welcome, listeners, to another edition of Ropecast, the podcast about English.
Hello.
Hello, Peter.
Hi, Roger. Hi, listeners.
You know, I've been thinking a little bit more, Peter, about etymology, that is, the origin of words.
You're not going to put me through another one of those crazy little silly quizzes of yours?
You don't like my quizzes?
They are kind of hard, and I think the listeners think they're too hard, too.
Right. But you said silly quizzes.
Yeah.
Yeah. What about that word silly?
What about it?
Does it remind you of a German word at all?
Of a German word?
Yeah.
Well, it means albern, so it's sort of like...
Stupid.
Stupid. Yeah. Yeah, but it doesn't really sound like silly, stupid, dumb, doom. Sail.
What about selig?
Selig.
Yeah.
Selig. Well, yeah, that's saint or yeah.
It's something very positive, isn't it?
Selig, yeah, sure.
Whereas silly is very negative.
Uh-huh.
But these words have a single origin.
Do they?
They are, if you like, the same word originally.
Okay.
And it's a very good illustration how you get from selig to silly.
We'd have to maybe translate selig into English for all of those that don't speak German. How would you translate selig?
Well, I suppose like blessed, perhaps.
Blessed.
Blessed. Something like that.
Yeah. And so it came from blessed to
stupid,
dumb.
Yeah. And this is a process that is a kind of downhill track that some words take.
Uh-huh.
Rather like people in society, you know, you can climb the social ladder,
right?
Or you can take a plunge. Mm-hmm.
And words do the same.
Exactly.
Uh-huh.
So this selig actually has a long and winding road from deserving of pity through something like insignificant,
right?
Then humble, simple origins.
Okay.
To plain and simple, and then through to foolish or stupid.
Oh, yeah. So simple has the derivation simpleton, which is a person who is not very intelligent.
Exactly.
So, uh-huh.
So that's
okay.
one of the processes that happens with words.
Okay. So this is a word that's gone downhill.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. But so on welfare, so to speak.
I'd like to give you another example because it just brings in my own family name.
Charlton?
Yeah.
Is that a downhill thing, too?
It is.
Oh, my God, you poor thing.
A possible origin of my name is from something that was certainly in Middle English, Old English, Cheol. Cheol was a free man. That is, not a slave, not owned by somebody else, but a free man.
Okay.
So that's relatively positive for the society of that period.
Okay, I get it.
And it has, again, quite a long history of change through a serf, another very rather low-level position in society, right down to an uneducated person or a person of low breeding.
Mm-hmm.
And in modern English, it would give us churl, which is hardly used anymore. It would mean someone who's miserly, who's very careful with money, who's the opposite of generous.
Well, you are, aren't you? Well, you're generous, okay, but careful with money. You're generous. He's a generous person, folks, but he knows how to deal with money as well.
So the only survival in modern English is the adjective churlish. We do use that.
Uh-huh.
Of someone who is, well, it's a very negative word, an impolite person, a very unfriendly person.
Okay, we'll have to put that on the website for people to look up. But is there also words that sort of made it, that have come from a poor origin and that move upwards?
It's called amelioration.
Amelioration.
Yes,
that's French, right?
That's going up in the world.
Going up in the world. Yeah. So what would be an example of that? Let's start.
Well, an adjective again. Lean. Lean originally was really rather negative. A lean person was one who simply didn't have enough to eat.
Skinny,
yes. Emaciated would be a learned word for this.
Yes, so that's really, you're so skinny, you're starving, basically.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. And that has gradually gone up the scale until, at least for developed countries, lean these days is thought of rather positively. You're athletic, you're good-looking.
You have lean management, which
exactly.
is good management without yes. too many people at the helm.
That's exactly it.
But it also shows you a little bit about, well, changing attitudes.
Yes.
Because, I don't know, 200 years back, being lean meant also that you might have starved if there wasn't enough food during the winter.
Yeah.
Whereas today, with the fridges and all, basically, you don't really need to stash all that much food somewhere.
Yeah.
So it's not as dangerous anymore, and all of a sudden, skinny people, well, are the well-to-do people.
That's right.
Wow, okay. Let's do a lean podcast and stop it here.
Okay.
Okay, goodbye to the listeners.
Goodbye.
You've been listening to Ropecast, brought to you by Saarland University, featuring Roger Charlton and Peter Tischer. Tune in for the next edifying episode on your podcast dial.